If you came to watch this video tutorial, then no doubt you want to learn how to edit the most important file in Marvel Ultimate Alliance, the Herostat. The file is called herostat.engb, and it's located in the game's data folder. We'll show you how to do it. To gain access to any of the tools used to edit the Herostat, you first become a forum member of Marvel Mods. If you haven't done that already, well, what are you waiting for? An invitation? Okay, here's an invite for you. Come join us at Marvel Mods! Our community is not toxic and full of drama like others around the internet. No minimum amount of posts, no download limits, no paywalls, and no asking of donations. Everything is for free. Once you've joined us, view the mod installation guide, as it's the go-to source for how to install and mod your game. We'll show you one way to edit the Herostat right now. Click section 4.2 to shortcut your way through the guide. At section 4.2, you'll find one of the programs used to edit the Herostat. It's called Xmlbcui. This is an original program used for editing data files, so many veteran members use it as a trusted method that never fails for those who know what they're doing. I myself, CMUX890, use it, and I can tell you personally that it's very easy to use. Click on the spoiler tag there, then click on the link where the arrow is pointing. It will take you to a Google page where you can download Xmlbcui. Simply click on the button that says Download. Another screen may appear where it says that Google Drive can't scan it for viruses, but we at Marvel Mods can assure you that this program is completely safe. Click on the button that says Download Anyway. It is best to choose a location that doesn't need admin privileges to allow for easy use, such as My Documents, or creating a folder on your desktop just for game editing. The EXE will look like this. Open it and follow the instructions to install it. Again, set it up in My Documents or a created game editing folder. Then create a shortcut to it on your desktop. Once you've installed it, you can right away use Xmlbcui. Wait, hold on a second.
Guys, I'd rather not say Xmlbcui over and over for this video. I sound like I'm reading an eye chart. Alright, I'll shorten it. It'll be easier. Trust me.
Sorry about that. Let's call this program CUI for short. Phew, so much better. Anyway, go to your game's data folder where the Herostat is. The method is simply copying and pasting, so just remember that Ctrl plus C is copy, and Ctrl plus V is paste. Now, highlight the herostat.engb file and copy it, then paste it at the folder where you're doing your game editing. Now click on the CUI shortcut. You'll see that orange square window to the upper left. Simply click File, then Decompile, which means to open. The Decompile window will appear. Now remember that Herostat file you copied to your game editing folder? Click on the first Browse button and search for that Herostat file. It will appear at the Decompile window. Now just click Accept. A black command prompt screen will appear that says it's going to decompile the herostat.engb file and to hit enter. So, go ahead and do that. Then a pop-up message will appear telling you to run edit to view the generated source. So, that's exactly what you do next. At the CUI program, click File, then Edit. This will open up your herostat file, ready to be edited. Also, a herostat.xml file will appear in your folder. That's what the text file that just opened up is. So, what is the Herostat? Well, it's the file that tells the game which heroes or villains are on your roster. Each character has a Herostat entry, including Captain America, which you see here. Scroll through this Herostat file to get yourself familiar with the syntax of it. There's an empty line before and after entry, except for the very first entry. That means no spaces. All entries have opening and closing brackets, and each line there ends with a semicolon. It's important to understand how Herostat entries are supposed to look. Now, suppose you want to replace Captain America with, let's say, Dante from Devil May Cry, for example. Excellent mod, by the way. It's easy to do it. First, keep note of the menu location number that the character you're replacing with has. In this case, it's 18. Then, open the Herostat of the new character, as all modded characters come with a text file that says Herostat. If you don't see it initially, it may be in its data folder. When you open your new mod up, such as Dante, you'll see his Herostat entry. After you've installed the new mod's contents into your game, change the menu location number from XX to where the replacing character is, which in this case is 18. Then press Ctrl plus A to select the Herostat entry, then press Ctrl plus C to copy it. You can then exit the new Herostat, but don't save it. Now go back to the Herostat file that opened. Highlight only the entry of the character you're replacing. In this case, Captain America, and press Ctrl plus V to paste. You'll now see the new character's entry there instead. Now look at the sign text again to make sure it's right. Empty line before, empty line after. Now you can save the file and exit. Next, go back to the CUI system. Simply click File, then Compile, which means to close. The compile window will appear, but look at the extension in the second line. It says XMLB, but that's not right. The Herostat's file extension is ENGB. So, be sure to erase the XMLB part and type in ENGB so that it saves correctly. Now just click Accept. A black command prompt screen will appear that says it's going to compile the Herostat.engb file and to hit Enter. So do just that. A confirmation message will appear on your screen, and a herostat.engb.back file will appear. You can delete that back file. Finally, drag the newly compiled herostat.engb file into your game's data folder. When it asks you to overwrite or replace the previous Herostat file, say yes. Now you can play the game, but remember, and we cannot stress this enough, Start a new game! You'd be surprised how many forget to do that. The changes you make to the Herostat won't work with saved games, so anytime you make changes to the Herostat, you have to start a new game. And that's it. See how easy that was? It's literally just copying and pasting. And you can do this with any character on your roster. The CUI system can open most other files in the game as well. Also, this method works the same way for X-Men Legends 2 with one difference. You don't need to worry about menu location numbers for that game. Now, the one drawback of the CUI system is that it doesn't really allow much room for error. If while compiling, the black command prompt screen quickly appears then leaves, that means there's an error somewhere. Maybe a missing bracket or semicolon, and it doesn't even tell you where the error is located. You're supposed to figure it out yourself. This is why some newcomers have problems with this otherwise simple system. So, get familiar with the syntax of Herostat entries. Once you do, the system will be as easy as pie. Some users may find the CUI system a little on the slow side in terms of editing speed. So, there is a solution. The XMLB batch tools. These batch files speed up the file editing process when using XMLB Compile, which is the program behind the CUI system we've been showing you. To install this, go to the mod installation guide at section 4.2, click on the spoiler tag, then on the link that arrow is pointing at. There are 11 contents inside this pack. The ones that start with RF are for those who use Raven formats, which will be covered in a different video. This video will focus on the ones that start with XC. So, let's reverse what we did earlier. Let's use these to replace Dante with Captain America. Simply drag and drop the Herostat.engb file into the folder with these contents, then double click XC Edit. This will open the file, and the text file will open for you to edit it. Keep the black command prompt window open. Get Captain America's Herostat from wherever you placed your character Herostats. Change the menu location number to 18 in this case, press Ctrl plus A to select all, then Ctrl plus C to copy. Now open the text file that appeared, find Dante's entry, highlight only that entry, and press Ctrl plus V to paste. It will now have Captain America's entry there instead. Save it, then exit. As soon as you exit, the batch file will automatically compile it for you. No need to change the extension XMLB to ENGB anymore. You can double-click the file that says cleanup to get rid of the text file and back file that you don't need. Now, same as before, just take that newly compiled Herostat.engb file over to your game's data folder. Say yes to overriding the previous one, and then play the game. But don't forget to...
Start a new game!
And you're done! Wow! That was even easier! If you ever have questions on any of this, you can always refer to the mod installation guide. If you still need help, you can visit us at our Discord server, and we'll try to help you out.
Well, guys, I think that about does it for today. All good? Yep, I gotta get a drink. You can run that outro now, fellas.
We'd like to thank every single one of you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, well, why not check out some of our other content too? Feel free to leave comments down below, but please do try to keep it civil. If you want to experience any mods shown off in our videos, check out and join our community over at www.marvelmods.com or our official Discord server. Links are in the description. See you all next time.